Equations of Lines and Planes, Level 7. In this video, we're going to go over slightly more challenging examples involving the scalar equation of a plane. Let's jump straight into the first example. Find the scalar equation of a plane through point B and parallel to the plane. In this problem, we are given the coordinates of a point and a scalar equation of a plane. We are asked to find the scalar equation of a plane that passes through point B and is parallel to the plane. In order to find the scalar equation of a plane, we need a point and a vector normal to the plane. We already know that both planes are parallel to each other, so both planes will also have the same normal vector. We can determine the normal vector of the plane by using the scalar equation of the plane parallel to it. So we take a look at the coefficients of the scalar equation of the plane and obtain the following normal vector. Now it is just a matter of using this normal vector along with point B to write the equation of the plane. So we substitute the coordinates of point B and the components of the normal vector. Then we simplify the expression. Doing that, we obtain the following scalar equation of the plane. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's take a look at the next example. Find the scalar equation of a plane that contains line L and is parallel to the plane. In this problem, we are given the parametric equations of a line and the scalar equation of a plane. We are asked to determine the scalar equation of a plane that contains line L and is parallel to the plane. Similar to the previous example, we need a point on the plane and a vector normal to the plane to write the scalar equation of the plane. Since the plane contains this line, we can determine a point on the plane by using the parametric equations of line L. Since any point on this line will also be on the plane, we can easily generate a point on the line by setting the parameter equal to a value. For simplicity's sake, let's set it equal to 0. Setting the parameter equal to 0, we obtain the following coordinates for the point. Now we need to determine a vector normal to the plane. We will obtain the components of this vector by using the coefficients of the scalar equation of the parallel plane. We could use these components for the normal vector, but remember that any constant multiple of this vector will also work. So let's divide these components by 2 to obtain nicer components. Now it is just a matter of substituting the coordinates of the point and the components of the normal vector. Then we go ahead and simplify the expression and move the constant to the other side. Doing that, we obtain the following scalar equation of the plane, and this is our final answer. Let's move along to the next example. Find the scalar equation of a plane that passes through the points A, B, and C. In this problem, we are given the coordinates of 3 points and are asked to determine the scalar equation of a plane that contains these 3 points. As usual, we need a point and a vector that is normal to the plane to write the scalar equation of the plane. We already know 3 points that are on the plane, so we got plenty of points to use for our initial point. What we don't have is a normal vector to the plane. We need to figure out a way to determine a normal vector. Notice that we have 3 non-collinear points. These points define a plane in space. We can generate 2 separate non-parallel vectors from these 3 points, and then we can use the cross product to find a vector that is perpendicular to both of these vectors. The vector that is obtained by crossing these 2 vectors can be used as the normal vector for the plane. So let's define one vector with initial point A and terminal point B as vector V, and a second vector with initial point A and terminal point C as vector W. Next, let's subtract the corresponding coordinates of the initial point with the corresponding coordinates of the terminal point for each vector. Doing that, we obtain the following components for vector V and vector W. Now we need to obtain a vector that is perpendicular to both of these vectors. So we go ahead and cross these vectors. Setting up the determinant and expanding by cofactors, we obtain the following vector. This vector is orthogonal to both vector V and vector W, as well as the plane that contains all three points. The last step is to substitute the coordinates of one of these points and the components of the normal vector. Let's use point A for our initial point. So we substitute the coordinates of point A and the components of the normal vector into the scalar equation of the plane. Simplifying and moving the constant to the other side, we obtain the following scalar equation of the plane. And this is our final answer. Let's go over the final example. Find the scalar equation of a plane that passes through point P and contains line L. In this problem, we are given the coordinates of a point and parametric equations of a line. We are asked to determine the scalar equation of a plane that passes through point P and contains line L. Similar to the previous problems, we need a point on the plane and a normal vector to the plane. We already have a point, so we need to figure out how to obtain the components of a vector normal to the plane. We need a way to define two non-parallel vectors that are on the plane so that we can cross them and obtain a normal vector, just like we did in the previous example. We can define one of these vectors just by inspection, by using the parametric equations of the line. Since this line is on the plane, the direction vector of this line will also be on the plane. Let's denote it as vector v. Now we need a second vector on the plane. We can create a second vector by using any point on the line as the initial point, and use point P as the terminal point. We first need to check and make sure that point P is not on the line, since we want our vectors to be non-parallel. We determine this by using the direction vector of the line. Point P will be on the line if there is a constant multiple of the direction vector that generates a displacement vector with terminal point P. So we go ahead and solve the following vector equation by breaking it down into components and solving for the constant. Notice that we obtain different values for the constant, so we now know that point P is not on the line. We can now define a second vector with an initial point on the line and terminal point P. Let's use the point on the line when the parameter t equals 0 for our initial point. Subtracting the corresponding coordinates of the initial point from the corresponding coordinates of point P, we obtain the following components of the vector. Let's denote it as vector w. Now that we have two non-parallel vectors on the plane, let's go ahead and cross them, so we can set up a determinant and expand by cofactors, obtaining the following vector. This vector is normal to both vector v and vector w, as well as the plane. Now it is just a matter of substituting the coordinates of point P and the components of the normal vector into the scalar equation of the plane. Doing that and simplifying, we obtain the following scalar equation of the plane. And this is our final answer. Alright, in our next video, we will go over how to determine the angle and the equation of a line between two intersecting planes.